So just to clarify, we are not in the renewable space.
Okay, but do you want to get
my,
into
my company, where we are, what we do is we are into air conditioning, the cold chain, fire safety, electronic security, and aviation, aircraft engines and Sikorsky, and helicopters. So yeah, it's a pretty broad spectrum. But I think there's one theme which is, you know, very relevant to this topic, which it, you know, it has to do with energy efficiency and fuel efficiency, which are very important to us. I think, you know, I completely agree with the comment that was made right up front with I think by the person that introduced us. With one modification, I would say, irrespective of whether a company is making profits or not, if the company is not, you know, growing in a resource-efficient way or not planning for it, then, you know, we're completely finished. The company is completely finished. I'll give three reasons for that. And they have to do not with so much the social or the environmental side standpoint, but the point that you know, Christian made, which is it makes business sense and it's a source for competitive advantage. The first reason is our customers are asking for it. So whether, you know, and the number one rule in business is understand what your customers, listen to your customers. So whether we want to move there or not, we know our customers want it. Examples would be, today, air conditioning, you know, is about 40% of a building's cost. By investing in, you know, cutting-edge compression, building controls technologies, we have been able to cut that by 30% to 40%. And what it does for the customer is it's an economic decision. It's not a decision based on environment or social reasons, but it pays back for them between 1 to 2 years. And they save a ton of, you know, money and resources when they buy these solutions. And it's not hypothetical. It's happening, you know, in India today. We have a large number of institutions, including, you know, within a 1 kilometer radius of here, a number of these institutions running. So it is, you know, I think that's one thing. Similarly, on aircraft engines, you know, we have developed the Geared Turbofan, which is an engine which has 16% reduction in fuel burn, 50% reduction in noise. And we've been able to get, you know, 3,000 orders in the last 18 months because customers have valued that, including over 400 in India from Go Air and IndiGo. You know, again, a clear example of driving value to the customer and what listening to the customer. What this means is innovating and obviously investing in new technologies is going to be very important. The second reason why I believe it's not an option is because looking at, you know, resource-efficient growth can drive bottom line to the company itself. So it's not about the solutions we make, but how we make them. Customers care about that, but more importantly, it also drives bottom line impact, equally importantly. We have, you know, reduced energy consumption by 20% in our Gurgaon facility with Carrier, and that I can tell you by example has driven significant bottom line impact. And the ideas there are not, you know, big investments. They are small investments with less than, you know, 1 year payback. It could be using daylighting in a building or, you know, using VFDs in pumps or, you know, small things that will lead to very quick payback, and it all adds up at the end of the day. The third reason why this is not an option, and perhaps the most important reason for us as a company, is it drives employee engagement. You know, that is something that we have noticed. You know, employees at the end of the day care about, they want to feel like they are contributing also to the environment around them, versus, you know, working in a company and making profits. And by training them, by making them accountable, and we have specific targets on, you know, all environmental goals, including myself as well as senior employees, that we have to meet. We get them energized around, you know, this area, and then you can also couple it with CSR work, where, you know, they feel that they are contributing, you know, to society. So this needs a lot of investment. It needs investment in training. It needs investment in systems, because we have to be able to baseline and then, you know, measure on a year-over-year basis, which we have done at UTC. But I think from an employee engagement standpoint, it is a significant, you know, benefit that we see. So, I mean, that's my summary. You know, I think it can deliver what customers want, you know, this bottom line impact, and employees can be engaged. And I think it's a must for all corporations. That's the way we look at it.
Thank you. Thank you. We're still waiting.